What is my job? If I come to know that certain activities which are prejudicial to the security and integrity of the country are going on, is it my duty to report to the Honorable President or not? And when the source of this information is Chief Minister himself, then is it not proper on my part to write to him and ask him why he has not shared this information with me and why he has kept me in dark and provide all the information? Now he is saying, I want you to hear especially. Now he is saying that he has never said there is any anti-national activity. I will write to you from the letter which he has written to me. He says there was absolutely no mention about any anti-national or anti-state activities going in the state or going in the state in any public statement made by me. I'm ready to believe him. But in the same letter, on page 2, he says, gold smuggling is activity which jeopardizes the national economy and also is one of the causes of tax leakage, etc. And what is important is, I made a general statement in the press briefing that the said activities are crimes against the nation. They are crimes against the nation, and the anti-state government is determined to. So I am not really able to understand whether a crime against the nation shall be viewed as an anti-national activity or what activity it will become. This is contradictory letter. He is saying that I have never said anti-national activity. And then on page 2 he is saying that what I have said, that crimes against the nation are being committed. Then crime against the nation is simple and pure anti. In fact, crime against the nation is more serious. Anti-national activity is a general term. So I do not know whether he really understands what he has written to me. And when he is saying that in Kerala, crime against the nation are being committed, I ask you whether it is my duty. Not that I am going to ask you to take any action, no. Is it my duty to apprise the Honorable President and the central government about this or not? It is my duty. If it is my duty, I would like to send a report in which I have all the information. I have tried to seek information. Chief Minister, I wrote on 10th of September. He did not acknowledge my letter till 8th of October. That is 27 days. Not only that he did not give reply, he did not even acknowledge the letter. And he is publicly saying and admitting in the letter, you can take it, that crimes against the nation are being committed. So what is the option before me? If the Chief Minister is keeping me in dark, he is refusing to acknowledge my letter, he is not giving reply to my letter, what I will do? This is not routine administrative matter. This is a very serious matter. And if it is a serious matter, I will ask the Chief Secretary or DGP, who have been coming regularly to Raj Bhavan, I will ask them to brief me to the extent that even for the promulgation of the ordinance, after the assembly has been summoned, which means technically assembly session has started and no ordinance can be issued, Chief Secretary along with other two secretaries, they come to the Raj Bhavan. they did not say they have been authorized by the Chief Minister. They say this is to bring state law in conformity with the central law. I tell them that technically, constitutionally, legally, it will not be right to issue an ordinance when the assembly is in session. Therefore, you re-examine it.